It's your family you gotta deal with. Mushy mushy. I'm ready to go. I'll wait for you at Serena, okay? Alright, I'll be right there. Checked out at Saka PD. Time to tie up any loose ends. Oh wait, is this like the last bit? No, I can't be reaching the end of the game already. So, this will be shorter than I think the other one. That giant cone's just giving me Majima's around the corner vibes for some reason. Like in the first game. Or, well, in the first. Oh my gosh, it's so weird to have like first and like second game whenever first game is a remake, or like the first game I played is a remake. But yeah, in one of, in the first of. That wasn't a prequel, I guess. That he was hiding in cones and all that stuff. Ooh. Stepping on the bike, doo-doo-doo-doo, stepping on the bike. All right. Into the madness. Took you long enough. Wow, rude much. What's wrong, planning on using that? Can't trust anyone anymore. Chief never once told me he used to work in Kamurocho. Did he owe you that information? I trusted him this whole time. It's not like Besho betrayed you. Yes, he did. Got no idea how hard I worked to get into Division 4. I thought he was the one guy who had my back. He didn't lie to you. Turns out he was making deals with Yakuza behind my back. That was before you were even in the force. Sorry for the detour. We gotta stop in at Osaka PD. Getting to the bottom of it. Jingguan comes first. Do what you want. I need to find Chairman Goda. Really? You don't get it. You're still in my custody. You don't get a choice here. Really? I've done everything to help you. And you're gonna threaten to kill me over not wanting to do what you want. Be clear. Fine. You're losing all your friends, lady, real fast. I gotta take a plane trip for this too. So rude. Sorry, we're full up on rooms right now. But this will do for a little chat, right? So, what can I do for you? Some odd 20 years ago, the Dojima family took on the Jingguan Mafia for control of Kamurocho. It was your case, wasn't
it?
What is this, an interrogation? Yeah, I was on the case. What of it? Chief, the Millennium Tower bombing, kidnapping of Jin Goda and Doigo Dojima. Looks like the Jingguan are involved. I'll ask you straight, is there anything you want to share? Stop acting so hostile to them. Nope. But chill out a sec. All I know is that what went down back then, no way I can know what's happening now. Fine, but then why didn't you tell me about the Jingguan? It was none of your business to begin with. I had no idea there was a connection, so I'm not gonna spill classified intel. Bad lead's worse than no lead. What's your reason? Yeah. Fine, then can you tell us what you know about the case 20 years ago? No prob, where to even start? This is probably old news, but I was up in Kamurocho's Division 4. I heard. And you made the Dojima family do your job. Well, it ain't that simple. But yeah, it was the only way. Cops couldn't do a thing. We couldn't find him. Daily looting beatings had folks scared bad. When the Jingwan hit Kamurocho, the city went to hell faster than we could react. But cutting deals with Yakuza behind the scenes is never the right call. It only leads to corruption. Was that practically your model?
Why?
There was no other way at the time. It all changed the question. The Jingwan are doing all right for an extinct mafia. Any ideas there? You know something, don't you? At the time, the Jingwan Mafia was a 36-man outfit. Of that, we only found 33 bodies. Meaning 3 survivors. Right. I know about one of them. Please tell me, Chief. Please. Place called Kaima, out in the city. You'll find him there. His name? These days he goes by Murai. Sayama. I'm the one who brought Murai to Osaka. I gave him the name Murai. It's a miracle he survived. And Jingwan Creed is death before dishonor. Revenge comes before staying alive for them. Murai broke that creed. So I helped him get at it, Kamurocho. Shield him from retribution of the others. Exactly. Gohara and I brought him with us when we got transferred to Kansai. Gohara got transferred to Kansai too. Yeah. Your protective custody job ends today. That's in order. And why is that? I'm gonna play on my headset. Alright, cool. The Jingwan are... Wait, what is this chauvinist BS? Draw Demon Boy later. No, it ain't like that. It's just outside Division 4's jurisdiction. Don't play that card now. My job is bringing criminals to justice. I'm not a criminal. Good night, man. This ain't just another Yakuza hunt. They're still just people. Only reason you can't say that is because you ain't seen the Jingwan's work. Even women and children are just meat for the fire. Oof. But I said that's an order, God. Stubborn as hell, that one. Look out for her, would ya? It's not my job. Why do I have to do everything? You're probably the one. Sorry. Wanted to call. I had a question for you, too. You know about Kamura-san's shootings? Are those related to the Dojima Jingwan incident by chance? Wait, did he kill him and transfer to Kansai? Like I've said too much. Just take good care of Sayama, would you? So wait, is Osaka now explorable too? Is there now an Osaka? I wonder where she ran off to. I should check in with her. Oh wait, Sotenbori is Osaka. Never mind, I totally forgot about that. Dang it, I'll intervene. Yeah. Oh, well, I didn't even have a choice. It just forced me to. I accidentally clicked X when they were around. Oh. And dead. Save my gun. Nice, nice, nice. I need to pawn some stuff off eventually. I hate that I have to watch them walk off. Also, you guys are totally gonna interfere with me. Hey, Kazuma Kiryu, that's me. Mind if I ask you a favor? That depends, what do you need? I mind doing some judo with us. I know it's kinda sudden, but you're doing us a great service. Judo? Who are you guys? Sorry, I guess it was rude not introducing myself. My name's Inuzaka, or Inuzuka. People call me Bero Kansai. I'm pretty hot in the amateur judo world. These guys all come in talents too. We're practically a bunch of stars. You heard me, right? The boar of Kansai. Doesn't sound familiar. I'm a bear, not a boar. The freaking Bero Kansai. Sorry, still not ringing a bell. Oh, just cut to the chase. Alright, point is, we got a request. We were told to throw down against Kazuma Kiryu. Who asked you to do that? Some swanky kid at our school goes by Kawuchi. I don't recognize the name. Wait, you guys are in high school? What do you sound so surprised? Anyways, that's why we asked it. If we do it, Kawuchi's gonna hand us each a cool 100 grand. You getting that hot for just a judo match? Well, it ain't exactly a judo match, it's more like a throwing match. Why is that? Just doing what Kawuchi says. We don't ask questions. Sorry, but this has nothing to do with me. I have no reason to fight you. Maybe you don't got a reason, but we do. I ain't about to let 100k slip through my fingers. That's not my problem. I'm out of here. Wait, Kawuchi said something else too. About how he was gonna get revenge on Kamaki school. What? What does old man Kamaki have to do with any of this? And what's with that part about Ben? Something doesn't add up. Anyway, we're on our hands and knees here, metaphorically speaking, of course. Would you fight us, Kiryu? Sure. Messed up and skipped that dialogue. Fine, I'll wait. I'll fight you, but I'm not gonna hold back, understand? First for me, rules are no punching allowed, only throwing. Come on, let's get down to business. Wait, can I still throw a punch? No, okay. I can only throw. Can I upgrade my throw real quick? No, I cannot. That's a shame. Actually, let's upgrade my attack limit. Also, essence of switch hitter. Sure. Why not? Get it while I can. Boost attack a bit. Alright, boost health once. Do they have lower health as a result? Alright, let's take you out first. First, you are collateral damage. Alright, you next. Only throwing allowed. Kinda sucks. Alright, good one. Alright, next. I'm gonna throw you against the wall. I don't know if that does any more damage. Come on. Get up! Those arms are too much. I wanna try again. Also, he is not in high school. I guess the other three, only the guy on the very right and maybe the very left, but not the guy in the middle or front. Nah, we good. Just fighting 100 grand. Kawuchi didn't say it about actually winning, huh? Anyways, we're out of here. Later, man. You truly are the heir to the Kamaki Kazuyo Kiryu. Who are you? You can call me Motoi. Motoi Kawuchi. Kawuchi? You're the guy Inuzuka was talking about. It's correct. Speaking of Inuzuka, I must apologize for earlier. It was merely a test of your ability. A test you passed with flying colors. Mind you, those were nationally respected judo starlets you threw around. Just who are you? A son of Kuishi, a school of martial arts, the rival to Kamaki school. Our styles have long stood as twin pillars of Japanese martial arts, the Kamaki school of the east and the Kawishi school of the west. My elder brother and I are the joint heirs to our school. What does that have to do with me? Last year, rumors swirled around Osaka about how Master Kamaki had passed down his secret techniques and his whole school. The heir, a man named Kazuma Kiryu. I have been tracking your movements for quite a while, Kiryu. Well, like, Kamaki never said anything about giving me a school. Believe what you will, but you know the rest of the world does not view it as you do. After all, what was that noise? After all, you are the only pupil Kamaki has ever trusted enough to teach his most beloved techniques. And let me guess, you want to beat me so you can drag Kamaki's reputation down. By the contrary, Kiryu-san, there's someone I would like you to defeat for me. Go on, my brother. Third master of the Kawaishi school, Kawaishi school. Defeat Gensho Kawaishi. You want me to beat up your brother? Indeed, it appears he has been possessed by an intense, all-consuming passion. You see, the Kawaishi school is known for its unique throwing technique, one of that my brother was quite well-versed in, but that failed to satisfy his desire for power. He would throw day in and day out, tormenting his opponents with his skill. Soon enough, he decided that there was no match for him here in Osaka, so he left to find the strongest opponent possible. About half a month ago, he showed his face in Kamarusho, having evidently learned of the foe he so strongly desired. Don't tell me. Indeed, his goal is to defeat you, Kazuma Kiryu, the Dragon of Dojima. As his brother, it pains me to see Gensho absorbed by such an irrational passion. I wish for him to return to his old ways, content in honing our school's sacred arts day after day. Please, you must use your might to break him free from the trance just so violently clouds his mind. I implore you. That's a hard story to believe. I won't let your brother throw his life away for some delusional goal. How can I find him? You mentioned that he had discovered a venue for your fight. Underground, apparently. Unfortunately, I know little about that. Maybe the Underground Coliseum? Yeah, definitely. Alright, I'll try to find your brother next time I'm in Kamarusha. You have my thanks, Kazuma, or Kiyu-san. Please, set him free from this wickedness. I will. Alright. Also, wait, was that a thing? I thought I saw dang it, no. Oh, no. Let me into the store. No, I want in. I don't want to fight. Let me in. No. Okay, wait. Can I get that, though? Ah, dang it. No, I want whatever's on the ground. That was fast enough. That tree really helped. Alright, where is that thing on the ground? It isn't a key, but something. Wait, if this is a key. Gold plate, no, it isn't. Okay. Where am I going? All the way over here, apparently. Oh, there's the BDSM. Thank you again for before. Ooh, wait. Hello, key. Where are you? There it is. Sotenbori locker. Okay, no. So the key tracker does work in Sotenbori. Yukihana-chan. What the heck was that? Another key? So you say. Have I even accessed the Osakan lockers? Oh, dang it. Alright. What the heck is that? Just suddenly fell to the ground for no reason. What is it? Sounds like the cowboy, or starts off at like cowboy bebop, like the 3, 2, 1, let's go. Mind you, I haven't seen that show, or that anime yet. It's one of those that I have to see eventually, obviously. Alright, give me something good, miss. Thank you so much. I like her outfit. What did she give me? The Aoi. Wait. Where is that? I can't remember the name of the old shop that did the massage stuff, but I don't think it's this. No, it isn't. Welcome. Oh, it's you, Sugar. Where is she? Don't know. That what's got her down, but I think she's out drinking at one of those bars again. She ducks into a bar and drowns her sorrow that way. They all know her name by now, but I couldn't tell you which one. I think a few bars might be around. I'll check around. Sounds like Kimura might want to, or Kaoru. Yeah, Kaoru might want to in mind. Because what? She got pissy that guy wouldn't tell her exactly the location of the business that he had a couple of years ago. Business might be a good partner. Sure. Alright, I forgot I gotta keep a lookout for businesses to sign onto the idol thing. I'm definitely gonna keep an eye out for them. I wonder if there's friendship ones, though, as well. Jeez, this place is big. Let me buy... I think I can buy underwear from here. While I'm here, so might as well. Might as well buy these. Ooh, strength ring. Alright, buy these. Thank you very much. What a bop this music is. Another key. I also saw another shine over here. Oh, it's just keys galore. Could today get any better? Still trying to play guitar. That poor fool. Yeah, today's a good day. Where is the thing to... I can't remember where it is. Let's see. Here we are. Hi there. Thank you very much. Is she in here? Can I go upstairs by chance? No, I cannot. So she's not in here. She's in the bar next door. Oh wait. Here it is. Castel. Or Stigi. Stigi? Stigil. I don't know how to pronounce it. Oh, wait. This way. Sorry, I thought it was the wrong way. Medium difficulty darts. Is that a... Are you okay? My head. It's itching like a mofo. That's what happens when you don't pay for a mug. That's probably not healthy. Come on, don't leave me hanging. Give me a witty comeback. Good, real zinger. I don't do that on command. So not funny? Sorry, comedy isn't really my thing. I wasn't expecting to be put on the spot. See you later. Wait, man, I ain't talking about you. I'm saying I'm not funny. That's why I can't get any good comebacks out of people. My setups are all cow dung. What? You're not wrong. That's real honest of you. Anywho, sorry to get all up in your business about it. My name is Minamizawa. I'm Kiryu. Listen, Kiryu-san. Me and an old buddy of mine used to be part of a knee-slapping comedy duo called Mars Fighters. Doubt you heard of us, though. The act never got off the ground. It's a comedy style called Manzai, where I played the funny guy and my bud Kitagawa was the straight man. Yeah, never heard of you. Oh, well, the reason I'm so down is, you see, the Grand Prix of Gags is right around the corner, but my buddy up and quit on me the other day. Maybe the cops wheeled him off. Guy had more porn sticking up his place than every sex shop in town. That's gross, man. Or maybe aliens beamed down and messed up with his brain, probed him real good, if you know what I mean. Oh. These are jokes. I'm really not funny, huh? I tossed my life aside for a career in comedy, dreamed of being a star act since I cracked my first pun. But now my partner's gone, and I don't think I've got the chops to go solo. My setups are garbage. This is what The Rock at the bottom feels like, eh? Suppose I should help him? You can't give up now. If you don't want to give up, then you've got to try harder, right? Yeah, that ain't half wrong. The jokes are in my bones, and it's no use trying to bury him. Maybe I can make my big break. I just need a straight man for my act. What do you say, Kiyu-san? Have a partner up with me. That's a good joke. Joke, yeah. Anyway, thanks for hearing me out. I think I'll stick around in here and wet my whistle a bit. Good luck in the Grand Prix. Thanks. Hello. Is there a woman named Sayama here? Oh, Kiryu? She left not long ago. She said she was heading out to the river. Maybe she's hoping to relax a little? Okay, thanks. Wait, can I actually... Wait, am I supposed to help him out? Heard Minasawa out. Something's gonna happen once I leave, right? I thought someone was gonna come out of the elevator that time. You think it's okay to glare at a guy like that? Well, it ain't. I wasn't glaring at anyone. I saw those furrowed eyebrows, but don't think you're wearing. Calm down, you're imagining things. Oh, and you're making fun of me, huh? I ain't gonna stand for this. Hope you're ready to get a taste of my fist. Sorry, I'm not hungry. It's just the one guy. Kitagawa. Not getting out of this fight that easy, man. Wait, I haven't done a drop kick in a while. Come on. Charge up again. Ooh, got him! Wait, cool your jets, no more. Hey, wait, it's Kitagawa. What did you call him? Kiryu-san, this guy's, my ex-partner, Kitagawa. From the Mars Fighters. Minasawa? The hell's gotten into you, Kitagawa? You're acting like a dumb thug. No time to talk. Gotta run. Kiryu-san, I'm slower than molasses going uphill. You mind chasing that fool down for me? Seriously? Fine. Hey, slow down. Don't hurt me! Why'd you dart off like that, Kitagawa? He asked you a question, or do you need help finding the words? I'll talk. Give it to me straight, Kitagawa. Why'd you up and disappear on me? Your setup suck harder than a cheap hooker. You don't give a guy anything he can work with. Dude, analogy aside, he's got a point. Can't say I didn't realize it. It ain't like my comebacks were much better. We got laughs, what, maybe once every show? I just don't think we're cut out for comedy, man. So that's why I quit. Kitagawa, say, what do you get yourself into then? Why are you running around town acting like a Yakuza? After I quit, I found myself sipping iced tea in a manga cafe trying to find some meaning to life. Iced tea and manga? The hell's gotten into you? So I read this epic story about this manly Yakuza, but when I finished reading it, I just felt empty, you know? I thought maybe I'd become a Yakuza myself and the story would never have to end. Man, you're dumber than a sack of bricks. That ain't a reason to turn the life to crime. Wake up. Maybe you're the straight man and he's the punchline, because he actually kind of funny. Ouch, man. Don't hit me like that. You'll ruin a face made for showbiz. More like a face made for mugshots. You're gonna knock my toupee out of place. Wait, you're bald? You know, it feels like we never broke up. This feels just like it did back when we were on stage. Hey, hold up, eh? Ain't this good? What, that dish rag on your head looks like, if you ask me? Nah, I'm talking about this dynamic. Can't you feel it? Actually, I'm playing the funny guy to your straight man. You're right. We were trying to make me the funny guy, but it turns out you're way better at it. And you're the straight man. You're some ferocious comebacks, by the way. I can almost feel my hair coming back. That ain't hair, that's confidence, buddy. Your hair's a lost cause. Okay, that was pretty good. We're gonna rock the Grand Prix. What's with the music? Kitagawa, you really think we can do it? Ain't a doubt in my mind. Mars Fighters are back, baby. I can't thank you enough, Kiryu-san. This is all because of you. If you didn't push me out the door of that sad bar, I might have kissed comedy goodbye forever. And if you hadn't screamed my brains with those fists, I wouldn't be half as funny as I am now. You're the one who started the fight, Twinkle Toes. I do believe you owe a man apology. Guess you're right. Sorry, man. You never change. This time, I quit. Hold the phone, we just got back together. Yeah, and I'm regretting my life choices. That's all. Thanks for tuning in. You know, they're not half bad. Hold hands now. That was pretty good. I will give him that. So then Boriki, right, she's down by the river. At least that's what it said. Wrong way. Ah, dang it, I got sneezes now. That sucks. Got a nose for things like these. And unfortunately, that nose needs blowing. Dang it. I'm imagining something as weird as like a nose job. I don't know why. That's suddenly one of the weird thoughts I've had. Yeah, no, that shouldn't be a thing. Shouldn't be a joke. Ooh, there was a key over there. I missed it, unfortunately, but there's a key. Hey, baby, you all right? What the hell are you punks doing? Hey, baby. Something you wanna say? What do you think comes next if you try anything? Get out of here. Hold on. You're lighting my fire under my heart. And I'm supposed to care? Oh, you're one hot babe, you know? How about giving me and the boys some of that? You think that gross crap's funny? I'm dead serious, baby. Banging a cop would be some kinky. One more word and I'm busting all of you. Ooh, that pouty face does it for me. I love a woman who can put up a fight. Alright, Kiryu, time to step in. Show him who's pog champ. Are you? I'm her bodyguard. Looks like we got our work cut out for us, boys. Sotenbori thugs. Alright, get the guy with the taser first. All of them have tasers. Why? Ouch. Yep, there it is. I was looking for the stun gun. I can throw them in through the river, can't I? I forgot about that. Bye-bye. Ouch, stop hurting me. Okay, wait, where is his taser? Where'd his taser go? Didn't he drop it? He had to drop it, right? I wanna use the taser, like, special move. No, oh, dang it. Into the river you go. Two boys in the river, two on dry land. One in the heavens, one in the sand. Die, scum. Another day saved by Kazuma Kiryu, the hero, the male god, the masculine man. Hey, Come on. What do you mean? You can literally tell them nothing happened. You're a cop. You don't have to run away with me dramatically. Again, why? Sir. It's okay. We're cool friends, and totally not somewhat into each other, to some mild degree. What's so funny? Nothing. Just you and me. It's pretty crazy. Hey, you free tonight? I feel like going out. Care to join me? Why? Why are you suddenly into me? I feel like we've had almost no chemistry whatsoever. Other than the fact that we constantly help each other. Well, no, I help you, you threaten me with a gun to help you more. Come on, pick up the pace. Dang, she ate it straight off the stove. That's too hot. Gotta let it cool down a little bit.
Good swing.
Is she a pro or something? Is she my equivalent? Is that the deal? She's like what Kiryu would have done if he'd actually lived a good-ish life. Hey, why don't we pay for the club? You guys are, for being a cop in a Yakuza, you guys have no honor. Are there teddy bears in this game? It's kind of cute. I can't lie. It's kind of cute. I don't get the whole dynamic. I mean, I didn't between me and the other chick in the first game, mostly because we had, like, it gave us the, like, you're in love with her kind of deal, and never, it didn't feel like any development of love. Must have been a run on beer lately. No prob, it's a great view of the city. That hits the spot. Isn't that your second round today? Well, nothing beats a stiff drink after a workout. Pretty great spot. I know, right? It's nice up here. My treat for coming out with me. I don't usually take people to my secret spot, you know? Consider yourself lucky. Dang, there's some nice water effects. I'm feeling pretty good. Still thirsty? I'll buy. Thanks. You're so considerate. Flattery won't get you nothing but another beer, buddy. Well, it's true. Get out of here. You take me for the kind of girl who falls for one-liners like that? I was just calling it how I see it. Like I said, flattery's not earning you any brownie points. Not trying to earn anything. It's kinda cute how you fight every compliment. Oh, please. Nobody ever called me crap like kind or cute before. Tougher than half the force, they're terrified of me. You're kind of soft. In other words, I know flattery when I hear it. You're tough whenever you're in charge, but I didn't drag you out here so you could put the charm in. Those other guys just don't see it. What exactly? That you're a cop, but a woman too. You're my woman now. Don't let them tear you down. In life, I think the most important is to just be yourself. Well, I suppose. You're pushing back so hard against everything around you, right? Maybe you've kind of lost yourself in the process. I guarantee someone's gonna see the real you and cherish you for it. Those smoke effects are so nice. You okay? Shall we? I've had one too many. You know, I gave up on finding that kind of happiness. I got nothing against romance, but ain't for a girl like me. But thinking this way got me this far, made me who I am today. Not that anybody know how I feel. Nobody but me. Sad life. Yeah, you're right. I don't know much about your past. Regardless of what people say, I still think you're a kind soul. Might not be my place to say, so, but it's just one man's opinion. You know, you're a funny guy. Hard to believe you used to be a Yakuza. Isn't that my point? Until they get to know the real you, people's stereotypes don't mean much. You said you were tipsy. You good? You good, bro? I'm sure let's. I just want to watch the stars for a bit. Then I'll join. I'm meeting up with that survivor tomorrow, right? Better get some rest. Don't worry, I won't run off anywhere. No, I didn't think. You said you owed me for tonight, right? Take my advice, then. Right. I get it. I'll crash at Mama's place tonight. At Oi? I'll be waiting on the bridge at 10 a.m. Alright. Now I get the dynamic. Now I can see it. Now I can see how they... Hey. Cute. She got all soft on me. Ain't bad. Ain't half bad. I've got some time to kill. Mind it, maybe I'll check out the city. I kind of want to continue, if anything. I need to get food though, right? Yeah, I'm low on health. Smile Burger. We've eaten here before, haven't we? I've had all but these two. Ignore that. Alright. Thank you very much. Look forward to your return. Complete Smile Burger. Alright, where's the next place? Wait, this is a shop? What do I do here? Oh, pawn shop, actually. Welcome. Alright, I'm here to sell. Alright, dang it. Alright, I still need to sell things. Anything else I need to sell? Oh, platinum plate. A platinum plate's only worth 200,000. That's kind of lame. Thank you. Seeing you. Alright, cool. Alright, time to keep an eye out for keys again. And also, new food place. Is there a new food place nearby? There's this place, which I think I've eaten at in this. No, I have not. Not at least in this playthrough. Grilled marbled wagyu. Let's see. How about this? All of these consume 80. Yeah, let's just have these three. Delicious. Thank you very much. What was that? That's sharp. Dang it. Hey, why are you staring at your knife like that? Oh, hello there. I was just lost in thought. Trying to come up with a new beef dish for my customers. Not a bad idea. Everyone loves beef. Exactly, but you know what's holding me back? This knife. I need a new one, but I just haven't found one that felt right. Every craftsman needs a tool. Yes, a carpenter needs a hammer, a writer needs a pen, and a chef needs a knife. We can't even think without them. I understand. You'll never make a perfect dish if you can't trust your knife. Glad you see my side of it. Hey, you seem like a snap guy. If you come across any knives, would you mind bringing them by? Type of knives, like, fine, aren't usually the ones you cook with. I wouldn't know the first thing about a good knife. That's fine, it all comes to intuition. It feels right, I can work with it. A knife could be made from the highest grade steel in the world, but it doesn't mean it feels right. On the other hand, a humble alloy kitchen blade can be a chef's greatest asset, as long as it fits his style. I see, I'll do what I can to help. Thank you so much. Obtain a butcher's knife. Okay, so there goes the mystery. I was like, oh, am I gonna have to hand him, like, 50 different knives? No, just butchers. You know it already. Ooh, wait. Something. One's over here. Where? Where are you, buddy? Wait, is it in here? Not in here, is it? That's not. Where is it? Is it behind the car? No. Find one of these. A trash can? No? Where is it? Oh, up. There we are. I can't get into any of the- Oh, I can. What the heck is in this area? A locker key, apparently. Alright. That's neat. Is there- Nope. Okay, that's a little tricky, but alright. Cool, glad I found it. Alright, let's open these bad boys, see what's in here. Technique tome. Toughness is easy. Blackjack amulet. Two blackjack amulets. Stamina Royale. Stamina Spark. Stamina X. Wait, police baton. Switch it out for the bat. Fast amulet. And black belt. That's all of them. Alright. Well, glad I got it all. Or somewhat of it all. Oh, wait. Wrong area. It's overshot it. Everyone keeps running into me. So rude. Right? Where is it first? No, it's not. Is it down there? Can I get over here? I cannot, I don't think. I don't know. Oh, Kiryu-san, this was looking for part-time work so we can save money and do the degree. Worst part is, Kitagawa. Oh, you joined mod construction. Nice. That reminds you of my construction. Don't trigger, don't trigger. Thank you. Alright, A1. Ooh, the first one. Alright. There's so many people on the bridge. Who are you? That ain't my dragon, is it? It's a tattoo artist. That isn't him, is it? The guy who does my tattoo? Who the hell are you? What are you doing? You sure you won't regret throwing that away? Excuse me. The tattoo design, right? And not your average either. How did you... You a family man? Well, close enough. I like his outfit. Come on, son. Join me for a cup of tea. Follow me. Welcome home, Master. I've got a guest. Put it someplace you won't find it. Of course. Hey, don't just stand there. Go on. Lisa, make yourself comfortable. Yeah, sure. The name's Kazuhiro Fourth, Master Tattooist. I've had my practice here in Osaka... about as long as I can remember. You owe me one, son. You're basically the top artist in Kansai, as I've heard it. Oh, you've heard of me. Yes, from the master who did the piece on my back. Your back, huh? Certainly has some weight to it. An artist named Utobori the Second inked it. Utobori? The Utobori? You know him. Of course I know it. Tattoos may span the globe over, but it's a small world. Get to be a master, your name will get around. So can I ask why you were throw that design away? Oh, that. Because it's the one on Ryuji Goda's. The dragon's practically a family heirloom. Only acting Kazahari has the right to use it. The golden dragon. So you know it. Legendary Lord of the Four Great Gods, the Golden Dragon. The design's actually a bit of a family heirloom, passed down for generations. And why would you throw it away? Well, what was that? What happened, Akina? Master, Satoshi was just here and he took the design. What? It was stolen. Yeah, but... We know who did it. It's the master's first student. Wait, what's going on? Him and his war of succession are the reason I was trying to get rid of the accursed piece. Succession war, huh? Let me fill you in. I'm actually looking to retire soon. I was thinking Akina here could take up the name. Here. That's right. But the world of tattoos is a world of men, and Satoshi, my older pupil, didn't take too kindly to the idea. Satoshi is the thief. Yes, and he's 10 years my senior. Considering the world you come from, I'm sure you understand the importance of seniority, yes? Imagine someone 10 years your junior passing you up, and she's a woman at that. His pride and his ego are wounded. But you're naming Akina as your second because she's better, right? That's right. There's an art to tattoos that goes beyond simple skill or techniques. You're not a master until you can see your client's fate in the ink of your work. Satoshi's just not there yet. Master, but I don't... I know. Unfortunately, the other part of this little war is that Akina ain't willing to take the name. Nani? Why not? She won't tell me either. But she, even if she won't take it, I'm not about to hand it to Satoshi like it's some solid consolidation prize. He's not ready to be Kanzahori the Fifth. Now I see what you brought down the river. Right. And that's why Satoshi stole the dragon. If I won't give him the name, it seems he'll take it by force. Wait, what are you... My tattoo has a strong resemblance to the dragon. What? But, yes, a dragon. Really, but I'd heard Utobori gave that to a man in the Tosha clan. He considered his magnum opus, and that was almost 20 years back. I believe he's done a dragon since. Even I've heard that story. So you're really him? I'm Kazuma Kiryu, and yes, I was once in the Tosha clan. Incredible! Master Ujiboji taught me both the value and the weight the tattoo carries, which is why I won't stand by while Satoshi undermines all of it. I'm gonna get your design back, and in return, Akina, will you tell us why you refuse to take Kazahori's name? Akina, I think that's fair bargain. Satoshi has set up a shop in a building in Sofukushu. Got it. Sakafushi or Sukafushu? Interesting. Why tattoos of all? Wait, was that a place I can buy? Or was that a food place? Oh yeah, that was a place I can buy. Nice. Okay. Slowly increasing our, you know, list of clientele while I'm here. Also key. Alright, we're slowly gonna make our way over there. And by slowly, I mean incredibly slow. Because there's so many places I can buy. And I might as well get it now, because whenever I do the other stream, I don't want to be walking around looking for places to buy. Like I did for, like, the business stream. It was not fun, but it wasn't bad either. Quickly, none of these are places, are they? Oh, wait, you're the Nav rich guy, right? Might as well fight you. Ooh, clean. Alright. Don't care, I won't just because I'm lady. I don't want to see where this is going. Put the knife down. Leave me alone, I'm gonna run this back through. It ain't stopping. Let's see what you got. I think this... Hey, nobody's stabbing anyone. Just calm down and let's talk about it. None of your business. I'm... Guess you don't got it in ya. What's going on here? F if I know. Lady just runs up to me out of nowhere, yelling about how she's gonna kill me. But she poured all her cash into a host club, and now she's taking it out on the first host she fought. Anyhow, I got a jet. Be careful, you hear? Are you okay? I'm sorry. Why didn't you tell me what's going on? Okay, my name's Yuriko. I got a sister, much younger than me. Than Miki. Up till last year, she was working in Sodenbori. She got scammed. These horrible men took everything she had. Not even that was enough for him. One day, they kidnapped her, locked her up, abused her, kept her in a cage like she was some kind of wild dog. It's been a whole year since, and cops haven't lifted a finger. Figured out who was her, though. That is one of them. When I saw him, I just couldn't hold back anymore. I was gonna use this knife and get it back at him, but he didn't. Couldn't muster up the courage. That was the right choice. Killing that man won't find your sister any faster. Smarter ways to go about that. What's your name? It's Kiryu. You're right. Ah, dang it. Okay, stabbing him ain't gonna bring Miki back. It's kind of a long shot, but have you ever seen Miki before? She looks like this. Yeah. Well, sorry, I can't say I have. Right, of course you haven't. Miki and I, we lost her parents years ago. She's the only family I've left. I want to help her, but there's nothing I can do. The cops ignoring me. People don't take me seriously. Hell, I don't even have the guts to stab one of those who took her. Yuji-san, I know this is crazy for me. Asking this, but do you think you can help find Miki for me? I'll do anything you want. If you've managed to find her, just please save my sister. I'm begging you, Kiryu-san. Sure, sounds good. Alright, Kiryu-san, thank you so much. Let's talk details. You said you have info on the guys who kidnapped Miki. What do you know? Pictures here. Photo of Yagi, photo of Kiari, and photo of Kojima. The first one's a host. Name's Yagi. He's the guy who just got here. He makes his money by targeting lonely single ladies. This guy is the absolute scum of the earth. The second photo is a man named Kajiwara, realtor. At least that's what he calls himself. More like land shark, if you ask me. Folks around here despise him. The last photo goes by Kojima. Ain't nobody sure if that's his real name, though. Guy's impossible to pin down. If I had to guess, I'd say he's the one running the whole operation. He looks like a regular old businessman on the outside. But somehow he's one of the richest men in the country. No way is he getting all that through legal means. These are the guys who got Miki, I'm sure of it. Okay, I'll see what I can find out. You got a real heart of gold, Kiryu-san. I can't find the words to tell you how much this means. Where's guy Yagi? We're gonna get a club over on East Shupuku Street. I'm counting on you, Kiryu-san. Gotcha.
I'll do it for you.
Wait. Is it over here? Oh no, it's upstairs. Interesting. Dude, I find it so weird that I can actually go upstairs now. Something on the ground, a blue bun. Let's check over here. Anything over here? Gotta be a key, right? No, nothing. It's gotta be keys everywhere. Where? Can I get in? Let me in. No? Where is it? Downstairs. No, it's gotta be under here, right? No? Is it downstairs? Dang it. I can't tell. I can't tell. It's downstairs. It's gotta be downstairs. Oh, wait. Maybe it's on the other side of the wall. Nice one, bro. Yeah, this is all I need to become Kazahori the Fifth. The guy with its dragon on his back is the talk of the town right now. And the rest of Osaka wants in on the ink that made a legend. They'll come converge. Oh, dang it. I was hoping to sneak by him. Boy. You're Satoshi? Yeah, and who the hell are you? I'm here to take back the design you stole from your master. I'll be taking the dragon. Oh, so Akina is sending heavies after us now. No, I'm here because you don't deserve that design. Who the think you are talking to me like that? You know how many Yakuza we've dealt with over these years. It's almost like you always think you're tougher than you are. Then we're done talking. But I guess you haven't learned to fear yet. I'll teach you. That's our line, a-hole. You're gonna regret coming here. Okay, wait, is it in the corner? Ah, I don't see it, at least. Let's see. Extreme heat. Just get bullied in the corner, Satoshi. Let your friends watch as they realize what kind of sniveling brat you are. Yes. Ooh, body slam him onto the table. Or I guess what remain of the table. Alright. Nigashani, I'm sorry about this. You really should pick your friends better. Ouch. That was actually pretty cool. Shame I had to beat you. Who are you? Kiryu-san. I got your design back. Oh, can't you see she's got you wrapped around her finger? Satoshi, you're blind. You don't understand the true artistry of tattoos. What are you babbling about? Your fingers know their way around the ink, but your soul can't see the colors. That's the difference between you and Akina. More of this pretentious BS. Tattoos are a permanent part of a person's life, Satoshi. It changes them. Someone like you, who just put an ink on two-bit street punks for money, just goes to prove what little you contribute to the art. A tattoo nurtures the man who bears it, and in turn, the design finds its home on their skin. Oh yeah, then call me master. Then tell me master. Who's got the golden dragon on his back now? He's some great hero? Say his name. Who does have that dragon? His name? Ryuji Goda. What? Yeah, that Ryuji Goda. You gave your ultimate tattoo to some crazy... And now you want to lecture me about art? It's not true. The master gave him that tattoo. Akina. What? I was the one who inked the golden dragon. 10 years ago, first laid eyes on Ryuji Goda. I was dumbstruck. I knew then that the man would be the finest Candace. I decided to inscribe the family dragon. But after I'd started the outlines, my hands froze up. Couldn't move a muscle. It's true. I took over and I finished the master statue. Really? That too was yours? That's how I learned the true weight of being a tattoo artist. And I've never been more scared. Yuji go to climb the ranks of the Yomi Alliance, and now he's clawing his way towards the throne itself. I never dreamed a man bearing my ink could become part of that. Akina, that's why you deserve the name. Master Teotsu is calling it. Calling is to make bigger men of their clients. That's why you rejected Kasahori's name. Yes, I'm afraid of giving men like him more power, Akina. Akina. That's... It's... Utobori-san's dragon. Ever since I took this dragon, I've gained a lot and lost as much. But this dragon and the way my life has turned out are connected. I believe it's all fate. You weren't wrong to have given Ryuji go to the dragon. It's easy for men with power to stray. They're only human. But setting them straight isn't your job. The artist can lay the paths, but the man chooses which one to walk. Here you spit facts, Akina-san. The art that weighs heavy on you. How can you turn away from the Kazahori name that stands on Ryuji's path? Best of luck to you. Kiryu-san, I won't run anymore. Kazahori V, thank you for showing me that. Interesting. Chapter 11, The Iron Creed. It's almost 10 o'clock. Sayama is waiting for me at Iowa Bridge. Bridge. Alright. Let's get over there. Ah, dang it. It's a guitar man nearby? Or no? I thought I was about to get in the fight. So you ready? That was weird. Why was it blurry for like half? What's up? Is this a... and I got this bad feeling. Yeah. I don't think this is how this should be going. What if I'm one of the Jingguan survivors? How do you figure? I'm sure this is very dramatic if what Mama said is true. Then my parents were killed 20 years ago by the Tojo clan. It would make sense if the Tojo clan killed them in a single one raid. It would line up, wouldn't it? You, another Jingguan's. If this was the direction they took for this cutscene, I mean, good. You can't deny it's possible. I won't run away from my past. What am I supposed to do here? Let's get moving. And I see them walk along that bridge, and it's a beautiful scene. No? No, I definitely missed the entire cutscene there. The chief said we'll find Mirai somewhere called Keima. I need to hear what he has to say. You sure about this, though? Don't worry about me. Whatever you can say, I can handle it. But we'll need to hit the streets to see if we can find the place. That was weird. I don't know, not bad, but weird. Oh, what? She came at a weird angle for apparently following me this entire time. We'll fight him. That's him, Yage, one of the guys who kidnapped Miki. Hey, I remember you. That cool off yet? She was at... You're freaking my mind. Let me tell you, do you know this girl? That's I've never seen her before. Might have been one of my customers over at the club, but you can't expect me to remember every chick who sets foot in there, can you? Stranger, I met someone who claims you conned her. Oh yeah? Bring him here, ain't nobody supposed to know that. So you do know her. Where is she? No effing clue. I was just doing what Kajiwara asked when I nabbed her. Girl could be anywhere now. Last memory I got is tying her up and having some fun. Girl's got a pretty great pair, believe me. Anyways, I don't know how you're connected to all this, but it looks like I'm gonna have to shut you up for good. Get ready to die. Yeah, no. Yeah, you don't get to live after doing that. You're not getting off this any easier. You die today, buddy. Good. And Scum is defeated. Tell me where Kawashiwara is. I don't freaking know. This guy says he, the golf center guy's got club on him. Good, if you want to deal with me again, then I suggest you relocate. Scum like you don't belong in the streets. Loser. Took the L like a champ. Like a little pug champ. Dang it, nah, I gotta fight him. Who's that guy in red? Dang it, I'm getting mauled for some reason all of a sudden. Whew. Dang it. Is there any food places on the way there? Ooh, wait. That's a place I can buy. And a new key. 2 for 1. Who could ask for a better deal? Worst case scenario. Ooh. Worst case scenario, if this is also a... Ooh, and I see another key, possibly. Dude, 3 keys in this one location. Like, they really like to jam all the keys in, like, single locations. And I'm not complaining. I like that I don't have to work much for it. Oh, wait, is this... Oh, no. Sorry about that. Let me help you here. Oh, me up. I think you mean feel me up. Don't think I didn't notice with those hands when Buster... Excuse me. Oh, please, even now you're trying to... I mean, like a hungry tie lion, you misunderstood, believe me, there's nothing further from my mind than that. Doubt it. I bet just, thought of getting handsy when we got your blood flowing south of the border. This lady is out of her mind, the Otenbori woman. And still with her terrible look. Otenbori strikes again. Or Obateri, my bad. Actually, yeah, no sane woman would step out of the door looking like this. You sizing me up now, fella? A lack of action got you on the verge of splurge. I should probably be going. Sorry for that bump again. Oi. Get back here, you old hag. What, you want a slice of pie too? Well, I ain't that apron looked at her. Don't give me that. I saw you shoplifting, huh? The only thing I steal is hearts, sonny. Oh, I thought that was a rim shot. You got the wrong lady, I'd say. Anyway, I was just leaving. Me and this chunk of hunk were heading out on a date, ain't that right, fella? What? So that's how it is, huh? You gotta pay your granny fetish under wraps, man. Anyway, you gotta keep... Hey, Patrick, how you doing? Hold on, all I did was bump into her. Wait. Oh, Sasaki. I gotta... Who's this Minetta of a grandma? She's the Obitarian. She was in, like, I think, I can't remember if she was in Yakuza 0. Actually, I'm almost certain it's Yakuza 0. Yeah, she was in Yakuza 0, and I guess she's now, like, 10 years older, which she should be dead at this point. She's really annoying and ugly. About that, I went and checked the tapes again. Turns out she ain't the one. What? So this old shrew? She's innocent. Sorry, this is all because of me. I told you so. What do you think you're doing to my street cred? I should sue, or at least get a few coupons off you. You should forgive them. You should forgive them. It's an easy mistake to make. Look, we're real sorry. Sorry ain't good enough. Those wild accusations had me blushing like a schoolgirl on Christmas Eve. Like I said, fork over a few coupons and we're good as gold. Got a problem, boss? Kadokawa-san, this old hag is trying to shake us down for coupons. Shake you down? You're the one who started it. Lady, this manager here has treated you real nice over the years. Why don't you run out of home? Like a wet on what now? Listen, I block out whatever she says. She's real bad. I'm blushing like a schoolgirl on Christmas Eve, I think was the exact phrase. Which, doesn't make any sense. Oh, so you think I'll back down after you tarnish my honor like that? Sometimes harm the elderly. Yes. But I don't take orders from tiny boys out here looking like leprechauns. You better shut your mouth, you purple-haired harpy. What, you wanna fight? Do you know who I am, sonny? They don't call me the Obitarian for nothing. Who cares? I ain't afraid to cut you one way or the other. This is turning ugly. I'll teach you what happens when you F with a Yakuza. Eek! As much as I hate her, I gotta save her. The hell do you think you're doing? You should be ashamed of yourself getting so worked up over an old woman. My hero? Oh yeah. Either way, I doubt you'd be much match for her. What was that? A woman like her? I can't explain why, but there's no way a two-bit thug like you could take her. Oh, you think? Huh? Well then, I'm gonna wreck this windbag after you're dead. It's weird how, like, people pull knives on me in the streets and everyone's, like, totally cool with it. Like, no one's concerned that this guy pulled out a full, like, bayonet knife on me. Or Bowie knife on me, my bad. And they're like, yeah, this is fine. It's just in the middle of the street. Like, stab him, and it's like the cops are nowhere to be seen except whenever it's inconvenient for us. We love game logic, yeah. It just works like that, you know? Come on. You just ruined my health, man. Shoot. Come on, let me... Onto the bike you go. What is an Obitarian to begin with? Finally, off the hook for now. Wait, let me look up what's... Define Obitarian. Period. Here, wait. What is an Obitarian? Obitarian is a selfish and unwilling, okay, it means middle-aged woman and Batarian. Japanese film, living dead. Japanese Obitarian behave in a manner not unlike flesh-eating zombies. The Obitarian is selfish and unwilling to abide by, or is oblivious of socially acceptable behavior. A typical Obitarian is short, stout, wears a perm, and is dressed unfashionably, house slippers optional. She will elbow her way through crowds, refuses to wait in line, and run the empty bus train seats loud. Some academics believe that the propensity for young Japanese women to transform into Obitarian is the cause of Japan's declining birth rate. Huh. So they're literally just people who are ugly. You got blood on that bike. It was a good looking bike too. Hey. I have no means of paying him back, so yeah, it was a good looking bike. Past tense. But watch your back. So an Obitarian is just someone, a middle-aged woman who's just has no social behavior. I can't believe I got dragged into this mess. I'm saved. Thank you, my guardian angel. Here's a little something for your trouble. Granny's gonna need thanks. You know, now that I'm seeing you up close, you're a real stud. Excuse me. This reminded me of that time a stunning young man with an eye patch came to my rescue. That's nice, but I should be going then. Etsuko X Kiryu. Yeah, no. Wait, it's Suko. Cool, your jet. Oh, yeah, him. Her name, Jang. Big boy, it's been 20 years since anyone set my heart ablaze like this. I ain't letting you get away. Wait, please. You ready? Here comes Granny. How dare you do this? Do you have this kind of strength? Bad touch, bad touch, bad touch. No need to go all mumble mouth on me, son. It's been a while since I had my oats, too. That was really something, ma'am. Sorry again for the misunderstanding. No worries, fella. I got all the compensation I was looking for right here. I've fought some battles in my time, but I've never fought strength like this. Obitarian, more like a tank battalion. She's so gross. Hello. Hey, excuse me, ever heard of a place called Kema? Kema, I've heard that name, but I couldn't tell you where it is. I see, the reason I know is because back in the day, I knew a guy was out there. What do you know? How about 3 big bills for the tip? Sure, 30,000's nothing, fine. Oh, I do enjoy smooth negotiation. Well, a deal's a deal. Mr. Clean, but make it homeless. Homeless with a beard. And Asian, but none of that matters. The guy who can get yen is a gambling man who goes by Gengaku. There's a run-down bar west of Shifuku Street called Mino. He used to hang out there. And that's all I know. Please, pleasure doing business with you. Okay, all I gotta say is, with all the... Why is she standing on the bike? Miss, you don't... Miss, it's a bike. That isn't how you ride it. Did your dad not teach you or something, or are you just stupid? Ma'am, get off the bike. Thank you, ma'am. That's me at school. I'm just saying, with all, like, the weird, like, race swap kind of deals, why aren't we getting, or, like, changes mascots? Oh, no, I'm real sorry, big guy. Yep, she's gonna be recruited onto my team. I know that back in SC, I don't know beauty, fellow runs joint, biggest fan too, he only one guy, sly pervy, good eye, nah, couldn't be. You can have it. Alright, Obitarian rides again. Yeah, oh, dang it. And the seniors keep yelling at me. Actually, not gonna lie, I stand on the bike parking things, and the seniors keep yelling at me, so I was bike. No, you're good, man. I'm assuming you mean, like, the weird, like, kind of loop-looking things. I do that all the time, too, though. Honestly, they're meant for standing on. No one puts their bikes on there. It's meant for standing on, by that logic. Time to eat food. Oh, right, I can't go in. Let's eat. Man, this is 30,000 yen. That's 25,000 yen. Sure. Alright. Thank you very much. I'm just saying, I'm surprised we haven't seen Black Mr. Clean yet. And I'm a little disappointed because I kinda wanna see what that abomination looks like. I just wanna know what chocolate Mr. Clean is. What kind of life he lives. I want to know his experiences. My dad is Black Mr. Clean. Solid. Dang it, now I'm imagining they call me Mr. Dirty. I don't mean it like, I just mean it in like the weirdest way possible, like Mr. Dirty. It's just the weird prawn version of Mr. Clean. Oh, that's so gross. But make it shorter and more muscular. What? I don't know why that's where my mind goes. My mind goes to the weirdest stuff sometimes. I'm not referring to your dad. Oh god. Okay, no good, it's locked. Wait. This person looks pretty old. Look, there's a phone number on it. I'll just jot this down. Phone number, remember? It's probably a cell phone. Give it a call, maybe? When you want to make a phone call, select phone number memo. It gets more and more cryptic.
During the Jumanji rock smolder while saying I'm Mr. Dirty wielding fighting you as you do an ostrich slocking back that slinger slang on your head.
You, my friend, have finally awakened a beast within me. You have woken something within me that I thought long since dormant.
Cheap slicing.
What is this? Love? Increased damage. I need more stuff. Employee of the month. Might as well grab it.
I have awoken your inner, Mr. Dirty.
The world is not ready for this. Alright, I actually do need to use this though. Valuable. Phone number memo. Yes.
Ring ring! Ring ring! Hello! This is pizza. The world is not ready for the power you.
That is why I shall never show my face. Or my devilishly good looks. They actually picked up. Hello. I have a reason to believe you can tell me about a place called Kama. There's this popular hostess down in the Red Sirloin. Goes by Yukina. And she goes from being pleasantly plump, her sizes, please. Pleasantly plump? Her sizes, please. What? Do with anything. There's this popular hostess. Okay, she's just repeating it. I don't know. What the? He hung up. I guess I gotta ask a girl about her weight and size. Which, you know, you're not supposed to know. But hey, I'm a gentleman at heart. Okay. What's in locker number one? Stamina XX. Silver plate. Pliers. How do I fight with pliers? I'm a little curious about that more than anything. Oh yeah, Joker card. Silver plate. Baseball. Put down the sword. Karna Maxver. And blood cake thing. Maybe, I don't know, snip the... What? I don't remember. I'm slightly unsure of the context of which... I'm assuming it's because I said my devilishly good looks. They cannot bear to hold or something like that. But, I was not expecting that conclusion to be drawn. I saw Bob Ross. Wait. Okay, wait. What do you mean, Bobby? Where is the boy? I don't see Bob Ross. Oh, dang, my partner is going to fight all of them. You mean that boy? You mean Guitar Man? Nah, he ain't Bob Ross. He's just got a bear. He's a guitar. Nah, he looks nothing like Bob Ross. Also, my partner is dying. How's she actually doing? Not bad. She does need my help, though. I kind of get where you're going for, though. Maybe he's Asian Bob Ross. I don't know. Together again. Alright, let's go get some wine. Guess we're going to a host club now. With a quite plump hostess, apparently. More locker key. All I ever live for in this game is locker key. Yukina-chan? I'm already missing Yukina-chan. Have you ever booked some body all other hostess? Cease to exist. I got her sizes, you know. She's 100, 100, 109, top to bottom. 110, so wait. 1119? Need a size again. 111. Wait, what? Wait, you do. She's 110.
109. Top to bottom.
What?
What is that? What am I supposed to... Uran House Club. That's so good. That's such a good... good, anime. Okay, wait, it's one... He's taking... I know, but... in the thing, it only lets me put four inputs in, is my my question. Because there's 110, 100, and then 109. So that doesn't fit it. Picked up. Hello, reason. Oh, wait. 110, I think? Oh, whoops. Dang it. I wasn't expecting to have to input. Dang it. Alright, call again. Come on, hurry up. Alright, I guess I gotta input all of them. Wishy wishy. Okay. 110. Dang it! Oh my gosh, I clicked too fast. I expect like a double input. I need to slow down and actually... I'm not used to being patient. That's my big problem. I'm never patient in life. Cool. Actually picked up. Alright. Mm-hmm. Rush. I was just trying to skip the dialogue. Just cries on stream. Again. Alright. Wait. Alright. Slow. 110. 100. 109. 110, 100, 109. That's right, make yourselves comfortable down at Mino for a spell. Hey, wait, what? Dang, yeah, I don't. Alright. Where's Mino? Over here? Oh no, come on, get out of the way, get out of the way. Also, that girl in the red outfit looks like Klee from Genshin Impact. Like, her outfit looks like Klee's. Please. Please don't follow me. Stop it. Go away. I don't want to hang out with you guys. Wait, is it the one down here? The door's unlocked. How strange. What smells so bad? Hasn't got much use lately. This note refers to shogi pieces from left to right. It says King, Gold General, Silver Pawn, or King, Gold General, Silver General, and Pawn. What's the significance, though? Shogi board has some pieces on it from left to right. Wait, what is it asking? From left to right, it says King, Gold General, Silver General, and Pawn. What's the significance, though? Am I supposed to do something? Oh, okay. Whenever I see a traffic code, it reminds me of PE when I use it to put them on my head. I'm very dumb, yes. Okay, get out of my way. Get out of my way. Okay, wait. So it goes King, Gold General, Silver General, and Pawn. So Shogi Bird has a piece on it. From left to right, it's the Gold General. So, okay, wait. This one I actually need. Where's my pencil? I just had it near me. Did I literally throw it on the ground as soon as I realized I didn't need it for the other one about the waist sizes? I think I legitimately threw it on the ground like a child. Okay, wait. So it goes, Gold General is 2. It goes King, Gold General. So wait. So King is the third one. So it's 4 to Silver General. Let's see, Silver General is the last one. So 4, 2, 8. And then Pawn is the fourth one, which is 5. So 4, 2, 8, 5, I think.
Oops. That's, don't scream. You know I was in the way, or you were in the way.
4, 2, 8, 5. No, like, wait, what? Did I do it wrong? King, Gold General, Silver General, and Pawn. Yeah. Okay, wait. So King... Wait, oh, King is... Wait, no, yeah, King is 4. Gold General is the first one, which is 2. Silver General is the last one, which is 8. And then I guess I counted Pawn wrong? Nope. Wait, it's 5. What? Wait. Gold General, Rook, King, Pawn, yeah. 4, 2, 8, 5. Did I input that wrong? Because Gold General, or Rook, King, Gold General, Silver General. From left to right. I'm sorry, did I... 4, did I input it wrong? 2, 8, 5. No luck. Okay, is it 5, 8, 2, 4 then? Am I... Did I did. Oh my gosh, I forgot my left from my right apparently. Oh my gosh. I don't think that's right now, is it? Oh, I was right. Okay, yeah, so it is. Oh my gosh, I forgot what left was right. What left and right are for a moment. Oh my gosh, that's embarrassing. What? Shareholders, stick it. Why? Hello. Well done. Wasn't that simple? Now go order a Christmas present and comb me. What the? He hung up. What is going on? I hope we're getting close. Yeah, so do I. I don't get this. Oh. Wait. Order a Christmas present at a traditional diner? Hi there. I was told to order a Christmas present? Ah, that. Just take a seat, sir.
With a sigh.
Itadakimasu? Are we actually eating? There's something hard in this. What the hell? Ryuma piece. Come see us again. Well, I found this in the food. Chogi piece, what do you think it means, though? Oh, hey, buddy, what a coincidence. Did you get to meet Gidengaku? No, but the latest scoop I jumped through ended up giving me this shogi piece. That's so? Oh, hey, that piece, that's not a Ryuma piece, is it? Excuse me? Look, why don't you just give me that piece, bud? Not like it means anything to you. Am I right? Still not sure what all this is supposed to mean, quite frankly. Then come on, hand over that piece. We're not gonna hand it over while we're in the middle of this wild goose chase. I wanna explain why it's so important. What are you happy? If you won't hand it over, it's only gonna bring you pain. Really? Again? Why are people so stupid? Oh, he brought a knife, that's why. He thinks that makes him tough. What is this music? All of a sudden. Not even gonna see the action. It's just that brutal. Backhand him. That didn't like no damage whatsoever. Come on, get him in the corner. Dude, imagine having the knife and getting cornered. Like you have the absolute biggest advantage. Like the human weapon system.
which is like our one great thing as a species that we have to defend ourselves with. Oh, come on. You failed it. Is like humans actually only have two natural means of their natural weapons, which is like their teeth and their fingernails and all that. But like they don't really do much. I mean the teeth do, but we don't really use them for fighting. So care to tell us what's so yap about this piece? It's your turn to be the yappy. That piece, it was crafted by a master considered a treasure among us shogi players. Basically a golden ticket into even the most underground shogi parlors. Any shogi player worth his salt would kill to have one. So I guess I'm letting you off the hook for today. I won't show no mercy next time. Why are you crying? Oh, my bestie just DM'd me at his gone Wattpad? Wait, his gone Wattpad? What do you mean? Like his, I'm assuming Hunter x Hunter fanfiction? It sounds like. Hello? Yeah. Oh, he's Hisoka x Gon. Oh. Oh no, wait, did he write it? It's his? It very illegal. Very wrong. Impressive work. That piece is quite coveted, so I'd be careful if I were you. Did he write it or did he just DM one? Come on, how long do we have to play this stupid game? He wrote it. Ugh. Oh, I didn't even watch much Hunter x Hunter, but isn't he literally like a... I don't know if you knew the new term for what they are, but maps and all that. I'm in Spain, but without the pain. You're in... Hisoka is 20-something. Is really his... Hisoka seems like 30. He looks like old. Oh, don't be that way. This is fun for me. Anyhow, no hard feelings, I hope. I just want to know where Kaima is. Give that piece to Santa Claus and his red-nosed reindeer will guide the way. What? Santa Claus? This is getting even more ridiculous. That's all help I'll give you. May your moves bring you closer to victory than ruin. Well, going by uncanon age, Hisoka is 40-something and Gon is 21. Of his canon age? So he aged him up? That's a new one. Wait... Do I have to go? Nikki. Excuse me, are you Santa Claus by any chance? Huh? You think it's about some nonsense? Just tell you, you're not. Sorry to bother you. You effing with me? Oh, come on. Why did they just start fighting me for no reason? Because Hunter x Hunter was made in 1999. That's always the weird, like, thing. It's like, does time pass for cartoon characters at all? Because my thing is, like, I've never been a fan of The Simpsons, but, like, after so many years, you've got to start, like, aging up your characters permanently kind of deal. Like, you got to make them living characters. That's my favorite thing about JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. I don't watch most of it, or I haven't watched a lot of it, but, like, the characters actually age, and it's a real world, and they die, and they're kind of, like... It feels like an actual story instead of just, let's have characters, you know, kind of just exist for a while. Like, perpetual ages. I only watched it for the cherry scene, and no regrets. Honestly, that scene is so funny. And then whenever, like, it gets to the real, I can't remember his name. He's one of my favorite characters, too. Whenever it gets to the real one, he's still, like, he does it the same thing. Also, did you know Jonah drinks piss? Does he actually? I feel like that's a joke, but it would not surprise me with how weird certain characters' habits are. I mean, technically, he can just turn piss into, like, whatever he wants, though, right? Because isn't his whole thing about changing into, like, things? He drank it in the anime. Ooh, yep. That makes sense. Yeah, I can see that. Let's see. You're not Santa Claus. You really drink piss. Again, when not. It was warm. Okay, honestly. You haven't seen as many, I doubt you've seen as many manga or like read as many manga or stuff. I've read manga about that. It's not, or I've read manga with that in it. I've read a manga about that. It's weird. There's a lot of weird. And manga, not hentai. It was a manga. You've got to be Santa, right? Someone you need should know. Show the piece. That piece. Who referred you? Gingaku. Don't know how you got it. But you're in my circus, ain't you? The only manga I've read is, to be honest, TBHK. Remind me what TBHK? Also, random one about Spice Girls. TBHK. That sounds. I don't know the acronym. Beastars is really good though. Ain't my monkey. Follow me. My toilet bound Hanako. Okay, yeah, the art style is magnifique for that one. We're running things from here today. If you want a really cool battle manga, my recommendation, Record of Ragnarok. It is a cherry on top of a cherry. Honestly, it has some of the best art. I can't spell. This ain't a date spot, kids. I'm not gonna have to play shogi, am I? And say you're surprised you got your hands on one. So who you playing? Murai. Yeah, Murai's our man. I'm gonna go to bed in a bit, eh? You have a wonderful night, man. I have to commit playing and... that sucks. Flying. It was terrible. This is what the board looked like after the 442nd move of the 1984 Meiji match. You do what the challenger promoted his bishop to 5-8. That's what sealed his defeat. Any pro would have known the right move would be silver general to 4-3 to defend the king. For some reason, Yutaba went on the offensive. People called it a rookie mistake, but I don't buy it. Nothing I know would be of interest to you, young lady like you. You got your name from Besho from Osaka PD. Don't worry, I work under Bush. I needed about Jingwan Mafia. You remember that night in Kamurocho, don't you? You're not getting away, old man. I think I may be one of the survivors. Were there any children there too young to remember? There was one. It was a boy. If he can live without knowing, he'll be better. After losing the Meiji match, you both quit shogi, fell to booze, and eventually died. After one shogi match? Really? He was bent on reaching the top, but my guess is he realized he couldn't cut it. He chose a move that defied fate, chose to die on his own terms. Weird way to hold a cigarette. Life can be cruel. You made it this far without knowing this. No reason to take on that burden now. There's nothing you can say that I can't handle. Famous last words. That's why I came here today. Please tell me what you know. I'm not moving until you do. I'm begging you. It was Christmas night. Merry Christmas. All your family's dead. We were all busy celebrating when the Doshima family burst. They killed with precision, one man after another. But you three managed to survive. Right. You managed to flee to Kansai with help from Kawara and Besho-san. Yeah, but men sent in from the mainland found me down there. Or down here. Yet, here I am today. Ah. I sold out my own. The other two survivors? Oh, not Daejin Kim and Young Minji. Daejin Kim and Young Minji. They were only 16 at the time, but somehow they made it out alive. Who knows where they are now? In that case, who'd you sell out? Truth is, there were two more. Two other survivors. They were boss's wife and her daughter. Her child, her son. You lying dog. Though I die, we'll live on. Nice. Shoot him. Shoot him twice. Do it 30 times. I don't care. You can die anyway. My child. Boss. Nightman. She, man came in shirtless. A shot of the shoulder. Man came full titty, missed my heart, and I survived. That night I was given the name Murai, and here I am today. Sayama's father was the Jingon boss. Where did his wife and her child go to? Both escaped with Kawara-san. So you sold a woman and her infant to the syndicate to save your own skin? Not sure what happened to them after that. The mother died. Only the child survived. You're really that poor kid? Who killed the father? I don't remember his name. Just his face. I remember his mustache. Kazuma. It has to be Kazuma-san. My father. The man who raised me. Shintaro Kazuma. You're sure? Dude had a mustache like a god. I was there too. Who the hell are... Well, lovely introduction. You're going mafia, I presume? That's right. Bombing and the kidnappings, you're the one? Absolutely. And we, you. You tracked down the deserter for us. Before you get to him, you're gonna tell me where Chairman Goda is being held. It's no use. They're elites straight from the main. No hell in hell to talk. You just threw away your knife, buddy. Well, you gonna tell me where Chairman Goda is or not? Hardly matters. You'll be in hell soon. Stab you through the stomach. Oops. Is there anything I can use? Me and the girl. This is... I really don't think she's... Because they keep referring to as the child, not her, him. But they would know the gender of the child, right? Or is that like something in Korean culture that you don't know? Also, wouldn't she be able to tell she's Korean? It makes more sense that Ryuji Goda is. Because Sayama wouldn't... Let's go ahead and get some health up in this biz. Stamina Royale. Alright, XX. We'll do the Stamina Royale. Choo. Right, and you're out of the count. Easy, easy fight. Fun. Get bullied. Now tell me where Chairman Goda is. Gosh, we can't protect anyone, can we? You're the single worst people ever. Cyanide pills. Should have followed it. Thinking a man like me who ruined so many lives had any right to lead a happy, normal. I was a fool. You can't beat fate. I should have died that night. I'll be sure. Tell your mother. Your little girl's grown up. And when she gets to heaven, she'll be like, I didn't have a girl, I had a son. Live to your fullest. I don't know what that means. I have no idea about Shogi. Oh, he committed seppuku. Well, partial seppuku, I guess? Did he make the promotion move that was, like, bad? And he's like, yeah, I'll go out on my own terms. Okay, wait, what is our involvement? Because we said we were there, too. Are you gonna get any clarification? Chapter 3 has been unlocked. I'm assuming that means we finished this chapter, right? 12, Osaka Castle. Alright. Probably gonna call it a game after this. Will you hear me out? No. That Christmas, I headed to the Dojima family office. Wait, what do you mean I was there that night? Okay, wait. So is it gonna be I was there that night, but I really had no involvement with it? Every Christmas, Kazuma-san used to grow or come to Sunflower at the orphanage I grew up to. But we hadn't seen him all that day. I was getting worried about him, so I snuck in to Kamurocho on my own. Man. It's been a while, sir. Why are you here? I wanted to talk to you. Not today, kid. Go home. I knew him to be a kind man. That night was different. I was worried, so I followed him. He's gonna defy his boss and let the Jingwan live. Of course, I didn't know that. You just let us walk away? On one condition, that you leave this town for good. Sounds like a trap to me. I couldn't hear what they were saying. I thought the old man was in danger. I just wanted to protect him. Call your men and head out the back. It's only a matter of time before they're all dead. You have to trust me. Wait, did he actually shoot me, or did he? I thought you were in danger. Oh dang, we caused him to murder everyone that day. Or at least him. Probably Shimano killed most of them. I'm pretty sure, isn't that Shimano? Lying tongue, though I die, we'll live on. It's only like the third time I've heard it. See you in hell. Breaking me, that's why he shot him. I didn't pull the trigger. Might as well have, but it may as well have been, yeah, me who killed your father. Again, we have no idea if it's father. Or are you going to shoot me? I told you I'd make this right. Oh, drop the tough guy act. You think that would do just go away if I take my revenge? Again, we have no confirmation. To make things fair, I should kill you. You should know nothing about life so black and white. Not sure how I feel about that walk. Psycho. It looks so way too stiff for some reason. How long have I been here? Nighttime. We've just been staring at this river all day. He really had nothing better to do? It's lovely, though. Kiryu, what are you trying to do? We only have this one suit. You're getting it all wet. What the heck is that bottle? Sorry. That was way too clean. Let's just go to a doctor now. Are we gonna collapse? No, we walking straight to the doctor. The blood's not stopping. Was there poison on the knife? I better get to AOE before it black out. Alright, if you get swept with thugs along the way, I can't run. Oh, that looks like a bad wound. Can I use health items? I totally can. They're like the kind of rude support of it. Can I get to the lockers by chance? Nah. We're dying here, no time for lockers. Where is it? It's all the way over there. Alright, just keep at slightly out of their line of sight. Yeah, the police aren't gonna help me at all. They see a man walking around with blood covered. Is there some kind of accident? No one's gonna call an ambulance for me? What kind of society is this? Alright. We're almost there. Well, I want to go to sleep now. The pan up doesn't mean he did this to me, did he? Or does it? Hey, the Goryeo clan put a little show in Sotenbori. The Koreans pulled that stunt on their own. They're doing so much of your work, it's hard to tell. Not that it got you anywhere. Picking a fight. Don't let him get to you. Look who's all grown up now. Since I've got the Omi Alliance chairmanship in my bed. What makes you think he won't just kill you too? You takes my bait, I take his head, bam. Plan that suits you, Senkirk. Hey, word on the street is Kiryu's a tough nut to crack. Suit yourself. I take it down, Kiryu, and hold your clay to my own way. Yeah. The game for the Omi throne. Is that the kanji for wind or something like that? What an annoying laugh. I want to break his face. Hey, take it easy, Mr. Tufka. That man sitting with, that was Kawara-san, wasn't it? Yeah, he was checking in on Kayara. What about her? Well, anyway, this is yours. Don't ask me, it was in your jacket. Did he really slip something into my jacket as well? You have your precious child, Sengoku. Oh, you're still alive? I'm about to get off. I can't stop you, but with that wound, you're pushing your luck. Just waiting for this cutscene to end so I could save. It's honestly been like a 10-minute cutscene. You've been back here at all? Are you worried about Kawaru, son? Kawaru, son? You hear me? Be careful out there, sugar. Spent more than 2 hours on my headset. Are you Kiryu? Wait, why is this a block number? VR? Oh, in VR. Okay, I was wondering what you meant by, like, in my headset. I was like, I thought you just meant listening to music for a bit. Who are you, and how did you get this number? Those ain't the questions that matter. You fool, you went Ruka back? Then listen up. Where is she, if you've heard her? No more questions. If you want her back, get down to Yokobori Golf Center and come alone. Hey, who the hell is this? Alright. Looks like Haruka's back in the story. The Yokobori Golf Center, fine. I could swear I've heard that voice, though. Alright. What is my completion status? 1 minigame, 6 of the clan creators, 0 of the Cabaret Club Grand Prix, 12 of the 76 stories. God, jeez, I've done absolutely nothing in this game. Apparently. Alright, thanks so much for hanging out. I'll go ahead and raid someone. I think someone else is live, right?